Welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar, and in this video we will learn how to auto fit a user form in Windows screen. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created a user form, and let me click on this button. Then you can see this user form has been auto fit in my screen. However, the size of this, the actual size of this user form is not this, but still it is being auto fit in my screen. And I also have a minimize maximize button, which I have told you in my earlier video. So this is the same button, the toggle button basically. So I'll tell you how we can auto fit our user form in any resolution screen, whether whatever is the size of these your screen. Okay, so let's start. I'm going to the Visual Basic, and let me close first. So this is the user form which I have created. So what I will tell you from the starting, so I'm inserting another user form from here. You can keep whatever size you want to keep of user form, but it will be auto fit automatically in your screen. To make it auto fit, double click on this user form, and I'll put the event on this user form activate. Let me remove this. Here first of all I'll put application dot window state. Why I'm taking application dot window state? Might be possible your Excel is in not maximize position. So what I'm doing here, I'm doing application means here the Excel application. Application dot window state is Excel maximize. So our Excel should be in maximize position. Okay, if it is not, then this code will do in maximize position of our Excel application. And now I'll put me dot height. Me dot height means the height of the form. So height of the form will be application dot height. So whatever the height of my application means, whatever the height of my Excel, that will be the height of my user form. Now me dot width equal to application. That's it. So first of all, let me tell you, if I'm not running this code and I'm just running my user form, then how it will look? It will look like this. This is the user form. Okay, and you can see here the screen here. So this is not in the auto fit condition, and this is the actual size of the user form one. Now let me decomment this. Run this. So this is the maximize position of the user form. But one more thing we have to do, that is go to the user form, right click on this and go to the properties. Here we can show the, we have to change the window state of the, sorry, the startup position of the user form, which is currently center owner, but I will take this Windows default. Now see, run. Here you go. So friends, that's how we can auto fit our user form. However, the size of the user form was different, but whatever size of your screen, it will auto fit automatically, because this is taking the height and width from your Excel height and width. Okay friends, now I have already told you how we can put a toggle button for minimize maximize this button in my earlier video. You can watch that video, but I'm telling in this video also. So I'm putting this toggle button and just click here. So as I have told you, the toggle button had two values. One is value true and false. By default value is false. So I'm taking toggle button one as minimize So I have taken this toggle button. Now double click here. So here I will put a condition: if me dot toggle button 1 dot value equal to true. So when the value equal to true means the form should be in minimize condition, else it should be in maximize condition. So when the form will be in minimize condition, then the toggle button caption will be maximize. So the text of the toggle button will be maximized when the user form in minimize position. And opposite to that, if our user form is in maximize condition, then the caption should be minimized. So let's check first. This is our user form and currently it is in maximized position. So the value is basically a false, then it is minimized. If the value is true, then it is maximized. Now I'm using the same code which I have used in my earlier video. Me dot first of all I'll change the height and width of the user form. When the value is true, then the user form height will be 50 and width also will be 50. And me dot top, so top you can take as per your screen resolution. Let's say I'm taking 450 here and the left is 0, it will be the position of the user form. I'll use this code here also. If it is in maximize position, then me dot height, which is user form dot height, will be application dot height, means whatever the height of my Excel application. And me dot width will be application dot width. And the top will be 0 and left will be 0 because we have our user form in maximize position. Okay, so it will start from the corner. And we also can change the toggle button position. So here we have to change the toggle button position. Me dot toggle button 1 dot left will be 0 and me dot toggle button 1 dot left, sorry, top will be 0. And we can change it. You can change the position of your toggle button as per your screen resolution. Here I'm taking let's say top is 6 and the height is 900, left is 900. Now let's check minimize, then you can see the user form is here. Maximize, but when I'm running this, then you can see the position of this minimize button is here. Ideally it should be here. So I have taken the toggle button dot left 900, means I have taken, I'm putting the toggle button here. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm putting one more code on user form activation. Me dot toggle button 1 dot left equal to 900, so it is by default 900. Okay, now let's check, it's working, but we are not able to click on this worksheet to work. So what I'm doing, as I have told in my earlier video, we have to change the property of this user form, and that is show model, so it should be false, then we will be able to work on the user on the worksheet also while user form is running. So let's say I can do anything here. If I want to work on the user form only, then I can maximize the user form and you can create your buttons and text boxes, whatever you want to do in your user forms. Okay friends, thank you so much for the watching.